Hello friends, I welcome you all for the third unit of Constitution of India. In this particular unit, we are going to discuss about the directive principle of state policy and fundamental duties. This unit is divided into two parts, A, that is directive principle of state policy, and in B, we are going to cover about the fundamental duties. Again, the A part is divided into part 1 and part 2. Let us have the part 1 in this particular discussion. These are the content that we are going to discuss during our session. Introduction, features of directive principle of state policy, and the classification of directive principle like socialist principle, Gandhian principle, and liberal intellectual principles. The directive principle of state policy are enumerated in part 4 of Constitution, from Article 36 to 51. The framer of the Constitution borrowed this idea from the Irish Constitution of 1937, which had copied it from the Spanish Constitution. Dr. B.R. Ambedkar described this principle as a novel feature of the Indian Constitution. Directive principle, along with the fundamental rights, contains the philosophy of the Constitution and is the soul of Constitution. Granville Austin has described the directive principle and fundamental duty rights as a conscience of the Constitution. Features of directive principle. The phrase directive principle of state policy denotes the ideal that the state should keep in mind while formulating the policies and enacting the laws. So we can say that the directive principles are the guidelines to frame the laws and policies for the legislative act. These are the constitutional instruction or the recommendation to the state in legislative, executive, and administrative matter. According to the Article 36, the term state in part 4 has the same meaning as in the part 3, dealing with the fundamental rights. Therefore, it includes the legislative and executive organs of the central and state government, all the local authorities and all other public authorities in the country. The directive principle resembles the instrument of the instruction enumerated in the Government of India Act of 1935. In the word of B.R. Ambedkar, the directive principle are like the instrument of instruction, which were issued to the Governor General and to the Governor of the colonies of the India by the British government under the Government of India Act 1935, which is called directive principle. Directive principle is merely another name of the instrument of instruction. So we can say the only difference is that they are instruction to the legislature and the executive. So we can say that the directive principles are the instrument or the tools or the guidelines to frame or the laws and to frame the policies, or we can say these are the instructions for the legislature and for the executives. The directive principle constitute a very comprehensive economical, social and political program for a modern democratic state. They aim at realizing the high ideal of the justice, liberty, equality and fraternity as outlined in the preamble of the Constitution. They embody the concept of a welfare state and not that of police state, which existed during the colonial era. In brief, they seek to establish economical and social democracy in the country. So the main soul of the directive principle is to establish the economic and social democracy. The concept is about the welfare state and not the police state. So the police not at the top. To keep the welfare of the state, the directive principles are framed. So it will establish the economic and social democracy in the country. The directive principles are non-justiciable in nature, that is, they are not legally enforceable by the court for their violation. Therefore, the government, it may be a central, state or local, cannot be compelled to implement them. So, the state, central and local government cannot compel or force. Compel means force. Force them to implement them. Nevertheless, the Constitution in Article 37 itself say that these principles are the fundamental in the governance of the country, and it shall be the duty of state to apply these principles in making laws. So, it gives the idea and it shows that the state government should apply these principles while making their state laws. Directive principle, though non-justiciable in nature, so we cannot justify these principles, we cannot put in the court, so it is having non-justiciable nature, help the court in examining the and determining the constitutional validity of the law. The Supreme Court has ruled many times that in determining the constitutionality of any law, if a court find that the law in question seeks to give effect to a directive principle, it may consider such law to be a reasonable in relation to Article 14 and Article 19. So, equality before law and six freedoms. And such save, thus save the such law from the unconstitutionality. The classification, directive principles are classified in the three, on the three principles, socialist, Gandhian, and the third one is the intellectual principle. Constitution does not contain any classification of the directive principle. However, on the basis of their content and direction, they can be classified into three broad categories, socialist, Gandhian, and liberal intellectual. First of all, let us discuss the socialist principle, what it tells. This principle reflects the ideology of socialism, that is Samajwad. They lay down the framework of democratic socialist state, aim to providing a social and economic justice, and set the path toward the welfare of the state. They direct the state first to promote the welfare of the people by securing a social order permeated by the justice, 50 social, economical and political, and to minimize the inequality in income, status, facilities and opportunities. It also led to secure the right to adequate mean of livelihood of all citizens, the equitable distribution of material resources of the community for the common goods, prevention of the concentration of wealth and means of production, equal pay for equal work for men and women, preservation of the health and strength of the workers and children against the forcible abuse, and opportunity for healthy development of the children. And third, talks about the to promote the equal justice and to provide a free legal aid to the poor. And the fourth is about the to secure the right to work, to education and to public assistance in case of unemployment, old age, sickness and disablement. The fifth is about to make a provision for just and human condition of work and maternity relief, to secure a living wage, a decent standard of life and social and cultural opportunity for all workers, according to the Article 43, to take a step to secure the participation of the worker in the management of industries, to raise the level of nutrition and the standard of living of people and to improve the public health. So it is about the social principle. So the social principle covers or it is intended to for the welfare of the social society and the all the constituent of the society. Whereas the Gandhian principle states that these principles are based on the Gandhian ideology. They represent the program of reconstruction enunciated by the Gandhi during the national movement. In order to fulfill the dream of Gandhi, some of its ideas were included as a directive principle. They required the states to organize the village panchayat and endow them with necessary powers and authority to enable them to function a unit of self-government. So according to the Gandhian principle, it allows to organize the village panchayat. To promote the cottage industry on an individual or cooperation basis in rural area. To promote the voluntary formation, autonomous functioning, democratic control and professional management of the cooperative societies. To promote the educational and economic interest of SC and ST and other weaker sections of the society and to protect them from the social injustice and exploitation. To prohibit the consumption of intoxicating drinks and drugs which are injurious to health. To prohibit the slaughters of cow, calves and other milch and draught cattle and to improve their breeds. Then the liberal intellectual principle. According to this, the principle includes the ideology of liberalism. They direct the state to secure for all the citizens a uniform civil code throughout the country. To provide early childhood care and education for all the children until they complete the age of 6 years. To organize the agricultural and animal husbandry to modern and scientific lines. To protect and improve the environment and to safeguard forest and wildlife. To protect the monument, places and objects of artistic or historic interest which are declared to be of national importance. Then, to separate the judiciary from the executive in the public service of the state. And the last one is to promote the international peace and security and the maintain just and honorable relation between the nations. To foster the respect of the international laws and treaty obligation and to encourage the settlement of international dispute by the arbitration. So, we seen that how the directive principles are the soul of the Indian Constitution and how these three principles have empowered our Constitution by providing the guiding lines to the states to empower their law and to frame the legal framework. Thank you for watching.